Leading gains on the NSE today are Mobil, Julius Berger, Total, of course, quite a few more companies also on the gainers board today. And joining me to discuss the trading day is Babajide Solanke, Research and Strategy Analyst at FSDH Merchant Bank. Jide, thank you very much for joining us. It looks like the market likely to close lower today. We're seeing losses in the likes of Forte Oil, Guinness, GT Bank, and Lafarge Wabco. But if we focus on some of the news today, Women Bank reporting a 266% increase in PAT. Looks like very cheering news to kick off the earnings season.
Yeah, it is. Thank you, Wally, for having me. Let me start with that. It is cheery news, particularly for Women Bank, given the long protracted years of non-performance by the bank. However, you know, as you said, well, let me quickly mention again that having cheap source of funds is a benefit, you know, for a bank and stock. But however, you know, if you understand that the company in its full-year financial account for 2013 does have a negative, the return earnings is a negative. That means that they need even more better performance, which is encouraging, and you need to sustain that in order for shareholders to benefit from any form of dividend distribution.
Right, we know Women Bank is coming from a very tough history. They have received a lot of support from new investments recently. So the turnaround story going on there, regional play. But let's move on to the others. The likes of GT Bank is falling today, down about 1 naira. But we know that they are going to report very soon. Do you think this is a stock to watch at this time?
Yeah, just stock to watch. I just think it's a temporary event in the terms of the decline in share price of GT Bank. GT Bank, as you know, the board is planning to meet sometime soon so that they can discuss that period result and possibly pay dividend based on an historical record of them paying half year dividend. So I think it's a temporary reversal in the fortunes of the stock price. I believe that will pick up as the market begins to reassess and look appropriately into the future potential of that stock.
Right, a stock that did well today is UACN, 62.50 naira. Does this still look attractive to you?
It still does. As it says, UACN going to about 70-75 naira per share. The stock, as you know, is a defensive stock given the vagaries of the economy and the challenges, you know, in the external economies. UACN is a stock that has diversified product mix that is able to weather the storm. So the stock has slashed some upside potential in the region of 70-75 naira per share.
Recently, we've seen some very strong interest in FBN Holdings. I wonder if that has anything to do with the results that we're expecting. Are you bullish on First Bank right now?
I am bullish on First Bank, strictly from the point of view of the valuation. It's relatively very cheap, given the P/E ratio compared to its peers. Moreover, if you look at the future earnings potential of First Bank, given the regulatory headwind that has happened in terms of the central bank monetary policy and that impacts the bank has clearly shown by the time it came to, when it came to give us the facts behind the figure and give us future likely development in that business, they've clearly shown to us how they're able to mitigate those regulatory headwinds in arising from the commission fees and commission income arising from the one of AMCON debit arising from the CRR on public sector deposits. We don't know how exposed they have to public sector deposits, but they've clearly shown how they're able to mitigate that going forward. So we expect some kind of slight improvement in the performance compared to Q1 2014.
Right, Jide, we've seen the latest GDP numbers, over 6% growth in the first quarter. We are going into an MPC next week. I wonder your thoughts about what we could see and what that could mean for the equity markets going forward.
You know, one thing that would dominate the MPC meeting, of course, being the first meeting of the new central bank governor, of course, would be exchange rate stability and possibility of not increasing interest rates so that it doesn't stymie or defeat the purpose of the central bank achieving its development agenda. And giving, of course, electionary spending going to the election year and a significant fiscal spending and the possibility on price stability, those would be the dominant factors. Of course, against the backdrop of international events in terms of economic activities and the global environment and most of the big emerging market economies. So I think we're not going to see any major change in the monetary policy stance of the central bank. I think it's just going to be reinforced. And I think all the rates that are monitored by the market from the MPR meeting, which is the MPC meeting, the CRR liquidity ratio will be maintained at the current level as for the last meeting in May.
Jide, a very quick thought on Dangote Sugar. We see the stock also up today to 93.39 naira kobo. Do you think we could see a rally in this stock going forward?
Yeah, I believe there will be a rally because if you notice that Dangote Sugar, if you see the cotton performance, you will see that there was an improvement over the full year figure in terms of the bottom line, in terms of the profit of the tax. So we expect that to continue, given that the price of sugar, which is a major raw material for sugar processing and sugar milling, the national market has kind of trended down. So we see that, we expect that to be reflected, you know, ultimately in the profit of the tax, you know, for the Q2 and in season. And I expect that result, of course, for people to look at that and believe that, of course, this stock will do well. And that is what is driving the stock, and that's what's going to even drive it even further.
Well, we know those numbers are coming out soon. We will continue to monitor the markets. Thank you so much, Jide Solanke, research and strategy analyst at FSDH Merchant Bank.